Missed Wife Swap this week? Well, I'll catch it on E4 tomorrow night at 9. Now, though, new series, new school, some strong language in Nearly Famous.
Salinger School. You decided that job at Tesco's wasn't for you. You turned down that sensible GNVQ in business studies. You ditched that practical degree in mathematics. And whether you want to be an actress, a writer, a dancer, or a musician, you've left behind everything that you know to chase your dreams. But chasing your dreams is one of the toughest things you can do. Everyone's doing it nowadays, hoping to live a life less ordinary. And most of them will fail. And the sad fact is that most of you will fail. I'm afraid, statistically, the odds are just against you. And that's why this school is one of the toughest to get into, the toughest. Because as far as I'm concerned, with all the competition that's out there, unless you're absolutely brilliant, well, there really isn't any point. So we expect you to get better every day. And we're not interested in people who are seeking their 5 minutes, who want to get their face on the front page of Heat magazine. No, we want more. Talk about. It'd be no surprise if this world was this sign in the hope that most of us remain colorblind. We are interested in students who will work hard to try and create something special to take us out of the drudgery of the everyday. So you'd better be prepared to work to try and create something amazing. So it's such a long way to travel. Go and unpack your things, because from tomorrow morning, the hard work begins. Just for tonight.
To the sounds of people passing by. You looked at me, something to say. You don't have to tell me. I think I know. Everything you touch turns to gold. If you want it that much, you should go it alone.
The answer's no.
You don't even know what I'm gonna ask.
Yeah, I do. It'll be, do you wanna get wasted, Kate? There's a party, there's guys. There's everything you're trying to avoid.
But you're my party friend. We have party history. I need you.
Yeah, all those years at school, when did you ever need my help being sociable?
All right, geezers, who's up for getting mashed up and then getting dirty with some of these actress bitches in it?
I think I'd rather tear my eyeballs out of their sockets.
It'll be okay, it will. I promise. Please don't be like that. I'm still.
So, sorry, Matt.
Are you trying to clean? That's so weird. You're a student, you're not going to give a shit.
Well, I do, because my room smells. Is it impolite to scrounge a cig before you even know someone's name?
My name's Lila. See, now it's polite.
Owen, thank you.
I'm Kate. I quit, but...
Someone puked on my floor.
Welcome to the Salinger School.
But it's going to be great here. It really is.
I mean, you're not even being sarcastic.
I work so hard just to get a place.
I did 3 months work experience at Hackney Empire and the lights and sound design of every sixth form drama production.
Yeah, I managed to enrage my entire family by quitting my oh-so-fruitful employment behind the counter at HMV.
Yeah, I made, you know, sacrifices and stuff too.
You see, we all gave up stuff to be here, so it has to turn out brilliantly. So, according to my mum, my life began in the back of a transit just off the M25 after an illegal rave. First few years of my life, we lived in this house here in Brixton. Then there was this guy we lived with for about a year. I never called him Dad. His name was Pete the Pothead. I went to a few different schools, moved around a lot. Mum mainly taught me to read using the Celestine prophecy. And then, when I was 11, things changed. When I was 11, sorry.
Let's move on. Jamie.
That was brilliant, wasn't it? Look, I'm Joe. Would anyone like to come to the bar with me? We could discuss the latest advancements in Pro Tools.
I'd want to go to the bar with you. Why?
Well, because we're on the same course and we might have things in common.
Look, right, I got into this because I went roading with a band for a year. Have you done anything like that?
I lit the set for the late and sixth form production of Mamma Mia. It wasn't that bad. I quite like ABBA.
We're gonna have to pay a lot of attention to the group work.
I thought we were whelming. I'm used to playing with some twats who were way, way worse than me, and you guys are like, just way worse.
Oh, it must be tough for you having to cope with those less gifted than yourself.
Yeah, man, sometimes it really is.
Okay, stop talking now. See me here, the teacher. I do the talking. Right, you get a break now, and then we're working on arrangements in pairs. You're gonna choose a track, arrange, and perform it. And don't just arrange it to sound exactly as it has before, put something original into it. Okay, Mimi, you're working with Ed. Rebecca with Beau, and Owen, you're working with Cal. Thank you.
I think I have more chance of relating musically to the college caretaker.
Well, that's a shame because the caretaker's busy. Come with me to fetch coffee. I've had a call about your accommodation fees. The finance department told me you're expecting some money to be transferred into your account, so your check were clear?
Yeah, my gran's left me some money. Not much, but enough.
Sorry to be the bearer of bad news, but the money has not been transferred and your cheque has bounced. Might want to make a few phone calls.
Now, you get to tell me
of your dreams? What performances have you seen that have expanded your mind? People go and see a West End show on a Saturday night. They've worked hard all week. They want to be taken away from all that. There's a Murakami quote, "What we seek is some kind of compensation for what we put up with." So, what do you seek?
I adore Sam Mendes, but only his theatre work.
Well, like Tom Cruise, like Mission Impossible. He's wicked.
I'm not into anime or, like, European cinema. I like telly.
Can you tell us why?
Because of Aaron Sorkin and Joss Whedon, because of Russell T Davies and Josh Schwartz, and because of Alan Ball.
Rachel Griffiths, because when you watch her, you really feel what she's feeling. She takes you into her world.
Good. I was worried we might have another Tom Cruise fan on our hands, and I'd have truly despaired. Right. Small assignments for you all. Monologues. I know you've done them before. Probably done some overacting in sixth form, hamming up the love scenes in Romeo and Juliet, making your mum cry, and everyone else feel slightly nauseous. But this time, I want something different. Something genuine. Try and give me the compensation that I seek. Oh, and Kate, according to the register, you've changed your surname?
Yeah, I had it changed over summer. I didn't want everyone knowing me because...
Well, why not? Your father's famous because he's very, very good. And it could help your career.
Yeah, it could, but getting somewhere because of him, I don't want that.
Good for you.
I know, but you'll be okay. You are safe. I made sure before I left.
You can't do this, Mum. I saw her will. I saw what she said. I don't care if she screwed up. It's what she wanted. You spent it on what? No. I was going to pay that too, just later, after college or something. But I need it, Mum. I can't afford to be here without it. When do I get to decide? Yeah, really nice, Mum. Really sweet. Why the fuck would I want to come home for Christmas anyway?
Some foxy 40-year-olds, add some sexy 20-somethings.
My favorite kind.
And then make them compete for the arm of one man. That man is Australian tennis ace Mark Philippoussis. And the show is E4's brand new Age of Love.
You're about to have fun.
If there's a connection, there's a connection. You can't help yourself.
I'm 48.
Wow.
Are you kidding me?
I think I'm up for the challenge.
Brand new Age of Love, part of E4's No Brainers. Wednesday at 10 on E4.
Yo, yo.
Oh.
Come on. Yo, yo. Frozen. Come on!
Vauxhall Corsa. What car's car of the year 2007?
Okie dokie. Breakfast. Mm. How's that maraca coming along?
It's going to sound great.
Hmm. Well, you know I could make rice make a sound without shaking it. First, Mr. Kellogg's takes a grain of rice, fluffs it up, and turns it into a Rice Krispie. Add the milk. And listen to the band. You know I used to be in a band, don't you? Who ever told you about it?
Yeah, you have.
All right.
Kellogg's Rice Krispies. Simple goodness.
protein bar with all natural ingredients.
I can only think of you. Wanna know if you're in action. I can only think of you. Give me a body.
Yes, I do.
Durex Play Vibrations, a vibrating ring for him to give pleasure for both of you. Durex Play.
To relax with.
Come in!
They're back in your living room. It's the Friends edition of Seen It, the DVD board game.
Now it's a party!
Test your knowledge with trivia from all 10 seasons. There's tons of clips, puzzlers, and questions.
Friends' favorite haunt.
Oh, Central Perk.
Oh my God!
Seen It, Friends. Have you seen it?
Soft tropical twist.
Packed with flavour.
It's as tropical as a hula dancer in Hawaiian Y fronts.
Mastication for the nation!
Frank, you didn't lock the gates, did you?
Sorry, Gordon.
Wait! It comes in peppermint too, you know! It's minty madness!
Come on!
Now you can get 0% finance on a Corsa for 3 years with a 20% deposit. Offer ends 4th of December. Conditions apply.
Something stupendous in all its awesomeness is about to happen.
I got a giant boogie on my nose.
Oh, that's just gross. Try again.
Here's a kiss with extra tongue.
Squelchy. But not on my watch, Blondie.
Talking very fast.
Oh, give up, you bunch of weirdos.
I think this time I'm actually going to kill them.
So, posing pouches at the ready. Bingo! It's the last episode of the series.
Bring your...
Hankies. You're not my mom, Jim!
Can I go now?
Yeah.
Brand new Scrubs, next Thursday at 9 on E4.
See that boy just starting over there. He stopped me today, said he liked my hair. Ooh. He asked me, where you coming tonight? And I said, I'm with my girls. Yeah.
Is that all right?
Concentrate on those extensions. I want to see your body's working.
I know you're not all dancers, but this is good for you. You have to let go of those long-held teenage boundaries. I want to see you all really trying in this class. Techies, set designers, actors. No whinging, no skiving. No, please, sir, I forgot to bring my leg warmers. This is the Salinger School. It's not about getting an easy life.
A word now. So you didn't hear the bit where the principal said that all first-year students have to do this?
Oh, seriously, in what way are making me learn the love of dance help me become a better musician?
Didn't we have this conversation at your interview? I mean, I remember explaining that it might make you less annoying.
And some of the best artists ever are annoying. Surely that kind of skill is only going to help me.
Look, I argued to get you in here, all right? You're a hard sell. Not many colleges would take the risk. You're incredibly talented, Owen. But everyone is worried.
I won't screw up again.
Yeah. But what I want to hear you say is that you won't hit anyone again.
I won't.
Because if anyone else misses a deadline or gets into a fight, we'll consider what happens to them. But for you, no consideration. Start packing immediately.
I want you to write about something that happened to you, that changed you and turned you into who you are. Make it personal and make it truthful, because understanding these things is part of what makes us better writers. And I would like it finished by class tomorrow. Thank you.
There's a modest mouse track. Uses the trumpet. Play the trumpet right, we could try it.
Modest mouse? You're right, because I want to be a wanker.
Good point. I mean, you've already got your hands full being arrogant and full of shit.
Fuck you, emo boy.
How's it going?
Brilliant.
Wicked.
But there were some girls at the bar wearing the most disgusting outfits. Mostly writers, obviously. We could have so much fun.
The answer's still no.
It's so stupid. You could flunk everything and just ask Daddy for a leading role. Fine. I'll go then.
Okay, so, my life did begin in the back of a transit van of the M25. I wasn't talking to myself. Well, I was talking to myself, but it's because of an assignment.
You decided against the crowded overexcitement then?
I was gonna go in there, but I...
So we don't need all this tedious fun-making. It's much cheaper and better to sit soberly alone.
Really? We're much cooler.
Straight edge. Only straight edge sucks, which means I'm gonna have to reconsider the whole concept.
We could reconsider it together.
Over alcohol? Lots of cheap alcohol?
I know a place you could get, it's really pretty.
I tend to think locations are relevant when it comes to drinking, but I could be persuaded. You gotta take that, right?
Hi.
I can crash you a whole one if you like.
I can't, I'm being good.
How's that working out for you?
It's surprisingly difficult.
Can you draw on a well-behaved past for inspiration?
No, I have no real knowledge of being well-behaved at all.
Sounds like you've got an interesting and entertaining life story.
Entertaining for some, maybe, but I'm not sharing it just now. I've got to get back to work.
It's distracting me from my work. And seriously, Whitney Houston. It's allowed being a twat.
Sorry, this coming from a guy who blasts out that all-time classic, I'm a Barbie Girl.
It's ironic.
Oh, aren't you clever and postmodern?
Yeah. Actually, I am.
Thanks.
Seriously, though, Whitney Houston.
Well, I think she's got a good voice. And I do believe the children are our future.
Show them all the beauty they possess inside, right?
Guess I better turn her down, though, if I want to survive. You know, in school, well, I wore what my mum told me to, and I always got good grades, so...
Popularity was an alien concept.
But here, I thought it'd be different. You know, like-minded people.
Not the tedious, thick ones who hate you for wearing the wrong trainers.
Anyway, turns out it's not that different.
So who keeps phoning you? My boyfriend?
No. I've never, really...
Shit. What have you been doing for 18 years?
Don't know. It's kind of embarrassing.
No, you know what, it's not. Giving some guy a blowjob at 13 is not big and it's not clever.
You gave someone a blowjob when you were 13?
I didn't swallow, I spat it on his shoe. It's not very dignified, please don't tell anyone.
I won't.
You mean that, don't you? Like, you're not even thinking it could be useful ammunition.
Why would I?
You're sweet. Kind of weird, but sweet.
Thanks.
Are you sure about this?
Well, it has to be worth a try.
Classic 80s ballads.
Actually, Classic 80s Ballads Volume 2 is better.
And you grew up in Hackney?
Well,
Everyone thought I was weird there too.
Can I borrow this? So we have to do this thing, right? And there are pretty much no other options right now. So there's this track that seriously isn't to either of our tastes, but I figured that's got to be easier than finding something we both like.
I'm with you so far.
Genius making them work together. Don't know why I ever doubt myself.
I still think you're a puss spot on the face of humanity.
I still think you're a game or twat.
But I wasn't as horrific as I was expecting.
It was fucking mint. I played brilliant, you know?
It was good, but it needs to be better. Because you two are performing at the open mic night tomorrow. So practice a lot. Make it brilliant. Impress everybody.
Bump, 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 gangster. Honey, honey, see me. Better not be more like a game girl, because easy. They call me shoulders, my popsicle is so sweet, see.
Yeah, he's this big shot director type. Wow. From geek to emo. You're making me hot. The new image makes me see you in a whole new light. You're doing lighting and sound, aren't you? Why don't you tell me all about it?
Okay, well, which area would you like to cover first? Because both subjects are vast and it's hard to know where to begin.
Why don't you begin by turning around and walking out of this bar? I don't really want to talk to you. You're tragic and annoying. The new image is never going to change that fact. Yeah, it's completely true. You can look her up online. Only don't tell her I told you, because for some weird reason she doesn't want people to know.
So, if you can get out your work, because you're going to read it to each other.
Can't we just hand it in?
Lila, how are you ever going to improve as a writer if you can't show your work to other people?
It's not just work, though, is it? It's something that actually happened, like you asked for.
Don't you think it's there anyway in the stories that you imagine?
It's not the same.
Just so you know, I'm fine to read mine out.
Well, you can do it then, but I can't.
Your phone, I take it. Give it to me. You can't have your phone on in class.
I need it.
Do you even want to be on this course?
Yes.
And give me your phone before I speak to the principal.
Fine, take it. I'm not reading anything out.
Hey, Kate. You heard about your dad?
That's wicked. Did he help get you in here? Is he directing something massive right now?
Oh, can he get me an audition?
Ash, fuck up. I was drunk, so I can't be held responsible.
I hate you, you know that, right? And your shoes are crap. Really last season.
I tried to call you to let you know I was coming, but you didn't pick up.
No. I tried, but...
Right. Well, can we go now? I mean... There's no point in us carrying on talking about it on the phone, is there? They were trying to poison me. Again. The neighbours. You don't want me to be poisoned, do you? You want me to be safe. Yeah.
Time for home now. Nice and safe. No more college. Mummy and Lila together again.
Life can be pretty bizarre.
I'm not scared of water. I'm scared of that advert.
So let Russell Brand be your guide.
What are you doing in there? I'm a decathlete!
As he ponders the meaning of existence.
You better watch out.
Yeah, you better watch out.
With the aid of some rather unusual clip-based material.
Hey, suck my toes! They're clean as a whistle.
Russell Brand.
Judge me on that information.
In Ponderland, next Thursday at 10 on E4.
Jimmy Carr, comedian on DVD.
I'm Jimmy Carr, one of the biggest faces in British comedy. Literally, I've got one of the biggest faces.
With an exclusive to DVD sketch show, out now.
Tesco Direct. This Christmas, order thousands of items online and have them delivered direct to your door. It's simple. Order everything from TVs to tableware and gifts to gadgets, all from the comfort of your sofa. Get all you want for Christmas at Tesco Direct. Every little helps.
Have your own Mr. Men adventure with your very own Mr. Men. Free inside special packs of Persil.
So we go out a few times, you know, just as mates.
Sure, mate.
And then one night, he smiles at me.
You seen Julie?
Yeah. And then he kisses me, real soft and slow, and I'm all tingling.
She okay?
But then he pulls away, and I'm like, what's wrong? And you never guess what he said. Your condoms or mine?
Nah, you're not. Nice one.
It was nice, you know.
You want the story? I'll spin it for you quick.
When the laws of science are broken,
I made you something.
The fate of their world will rest in the hands of a few. From Robert Rodriguez, the director of Sin City. Planet Terror.
Until Sunday at WH Smith, every one of our top 20 fiction hardbacks is half price. Kate Moss's Sepulchre is half price. Maeve Binchy's This Year It Will Be Different is half price. And Martina Cole's Faces is half price. They're all going down. This Christmas, think WH Smith.
When is a good deal not a good deal on home insurance?
When they attract you with introductory offers, but then you find out that there may be strings attached.
At Direct Line, we're currently offering all new customers 12 months for the price of 9. No catches.
That's better.
Well, you haven't claimed and there's no discount.
Oh, give me a discount. Oh, discount, discount.
And if you don't make a claim on our home insurance, we'll give you a 10% discount when you renew.
That's better.
When they have a snazzy website, but no one on the phone to help you.
Hello? Hello?
Hello. We not only have great online deals, we're on the phone in UK-only call centres.
That's better.
Direct Line. A good deal better.
Oh, I'm in pieces. When you've got colds and flu, you get a temperature and can feel lethargic. Benylin Cold and Flu has an ingredient that works with the hypothalamus, this blue bit, to help bring your temperature down. Phenylephrine widens your nasal passages, and analgesics relieve the aches and pains to help you feel altogether more human.
Benylin Cold and Flu. Powerful relief.
So did you have to audition like the rest of us to get in here?
No. They didn't make me audition, I just name dropped.
Really?
Of course I auditioned.
Hey, do you want to go for a drink together later?
Why? You've never bothered speaking to me before.
I was just asking. I'm being friendly. It's not because I know about your dad.
Morning.
I hope you've all been working yourselves to death in a bid to amaze and astound me. Kate, you're up first.
A career, money, a house with 5 bedrooms. Can I start again, please? A career, money, a house with 5 bedrooms. Who needs 5 bedrooms? What does it matter if you're on your own, if you feel like you don't fit in anywhere, like you don't belong anywhere? Shit, I'm sorry.
Come and see me later. Okay, Denise, you're next.
Didn't go so well then. Well, it might be more of a curse than a blessing, but I think you're all right.
I thought my music taste represented all that was wrong with the world.
Well, it does, but you have more than one brain cell, which is always a plus, and I kind of think you're unique.
I think I like being unique. It's a lot better than being a twat.
So what do you reckon?
If you could take my sarcasm, I could take your 80s ballads.
So are we, like, mates?
We can even say friends if you promise not to do anything weird like hug me.
How about a bloke's shoulder punch?
Perfect.
Do you think they've got?
They've probably got really boring parents.
I could take boring. I would love boring. Have you taken any meds since I've been gone, or did you flush them the second I shut the door? All those phone calls, did you ever think even once to call your CPN instead of me?
Don't trust that CPN, Lila. He wants to sleep with me.
I'm not coming, Mum. I'm not coming. And you can't make me. I'm going to stay here. And I'm going to do something with my life that doesn't involve you or your illness or your constant demands.
But you love me.
Yeah. But you're supposed to love me too, remember? You're supposed to want me to be happy. So is everybody.
Fine. Stay in this shithole then and be a selfish little bitch.
So what happened? Was it a simple case of nervous first-year line fluffing?
No. It's come out about my dad. And I mean, everyone is...
Watching you, judging you, willing you to fail.
All of the above.
Well, at the risk of sounding harsh, you better get used to it, because this is your life now. And getting people to recognize you as a person in your own right is always going to be a battle.
You know your pretty hangout plays especially girly.
Yeah, I know, I can be rubbish like that.
I'm not the only one who could be rubbish.
Yeah, right. You look cool even when you're walking or smoking or, like, sitting around being super cool with your guitar.
You think I look super cool with my guitar? Yeah, I knew that anyway. People say it all the time. Could be rubbish too, though, because...
because the cool thing's a bit of an act.
God, you can be annoyingly perceptive.
Mm-hmm. But I make you smile.
Yeah, you have a way of making things seem not quite so fucked.
It's my girly hangout face. It seeps in subconsciously and makes even cool boys smile. So what things seem fucked?
It's nothing. And if I want to stay here, I sort of have to magic money out of thin air and reinvent a whole new personality. Anyway, I thought we had a deal. Your location followed by my plan of action?
Yeah, I technically agree with you that it was the right thing to do.
If you don't, I'm going to drag you to the bar where I've heard there's a fascinating piece of interpretive dance taking place. I'll make you watch it. Worse, I'll make you appreciate it.
I'm going.
This may be a weird question, but do you know who I am?
No, but I know you're fit, innit?
Perfect. Would you like to get shit-faced with me?
Come in!
I was just wondering if I could have my phone back. I'm only asking because I just did something and now I'm worried. It's hard to explain, but this might help. I know I wouldn't read it out in class, but I do want to be here. I really do.
Do you want to go again? I reckon I got time.
No, I want to go back to the bar. I'm starting to regain some kind of coherence.
Okay, fresh-faced first year open mic night is about to get underway, and this is your night. So if you want to get involved, come up, put your names down on the list.
Are we talking?
Barely.
I knew it wouldn't last. Is it because everyone knows now? I even heard one guy say he used to screw Orlando Bloom, but he dumped you because you were so drugged up all the time. I told him it was all completely true.
Kelly, can you shut up?
No, don't. I want to know, who is she?
Duh, her dad is Mike Sherman.
Yeah, see, I'm into music, so that means, like, fuck all to me.
He's a very important director. Started out in social realism, but sensibly made the move to LA to direct films that actually make money.
Hey, seeing as we're, like, carnally close, you reckon you could give your dad one of my demos? Some of my stuff would be well meant on a film soundtrack.
These events are kind of terrifying. All these people, they look so comfortable.
Like they just know they'll be able to make conversation. And even if you don't feel like they do, you kind of have to come anyway.
You kind of have to be brave. Hey, where are you going?
I'm being brave.
I wish you'd told me. I should schedule in some more sessions for you. Despite it being hard, you have to open up to everybody or your work will never improve.
Okay. I will. I'll try.
By the way, as well as explaining a lot, it was a really good piece of writing.
I'm sorry about earlier. I do care, I really do. Please call me back.
You have got this under control, haven't you?
I'm trying.
It's not the best way to handle situations, losing it all the time.
I know, I've been told. My solicitor, the judge, everybody. It's better not to do anything. It's just the whole standing back thing. It's never been my strong point.
Well, things have to be different now.
I know.
I've got some work to do, but I'll be there before you go on stage, yeah?
Okay, let's get started. First up is Joe Bailey, who's one of the technical students, hoping to specialise in...
sound or lighting design.
Okay, and Joe's going to do... Actually, I've got no idea what Joe's going to do, so I'm going to go off and do some paperwork and leave you to your student-y frolics. Enjoy.
Hi, I'm going to stand over there. I want to show you what I think the stage should look like, because, well, I think it should be kind of special.
Cleaning wanker.
Part of why I've always been into this work is because with the right lights and the right sound, you can take reality and, you can make it better. And it should look better than reality. To look hopeful.
Hi, I'm Joe, and I'm a twat. I wear my jeans like this for sexual kicks, because it's the only way I'm going to get any. In my spare time, I like to clean and masturbate.
You're a moron.
Yeah? What are you going to do about it?
Hit me?
No, I am.
Oi! Come back here, you emo wanker!
Why? It's not like we're gonna be doing our cutie performance together now. Do you wanna come to my room? Help me down a bottle of whiskey and obliterate my memory.
Hey, can I come with you guys?
Hello? Yes, this is Lila Reed. Leave right away. My mum, she took some pills and the hospital, they don't even know she's going to make it.
Ever since I've been with Lana, I wake up wondering, is today going to be the day when she sees who I really am?
But it's inevitable. The war's about to begin.
He kidnapped Chloe. God knows what he'll do to her.
It's either kill or be killed.
If you don't honor the promise that you've made to my son, I will kill Clark Kent.
Brand new Smallville, Sunday at 9 on E4.
Oh, excuse me. A cough's your body's natural way of clearing mucus. Benelin chesty cough contains guaifenesin to help loosen the mucus and, you know, make it easier to shift. And there's menthol and syrup to soothe. Oh, feel better now I've got that off my chest. Benelin. Nothing is more effective without prescription.
Christmas starts inside this Saturday's Sun. We're giving away one of the best Christmas films of all time, Santa Claus the Movie, starring Dudley Moore, free inside every paper.
You'll see.
Plus, don't miss our Santa sack offer all next week with free gifts for all the family. The Sun's giveaway is so good, it'll put Santa out of a job. Get your free Santa Claus the Movie DVD inside this Saturday's Sun. Christmas with the Sun. We love it.
Ah, Barbie. Spend over £40 on Barbie and get this fabulous sleepover set with bag and torch absolutely free. Toys R Us. Open late till 10 p.m.
Come flying from high above.
Fill the stocking by the fireplace so you ever use that spoon.
Come on then, I thought you said you went to the gym each week.
There's something big happening at Asda this Christmas.
There you go.
Even more prices are being rolled back across the store on thousands of your favourites. From Coke to coffee and crisps to ketchup. So you can do your Christmas stocking up for less. That's Asda price.
Patch has got me through it. Looking forward to this.
You ready, love?
I think so. 3, 2, 1.
Group support worked for me.
I got advice by post and email.
There are loads of ways the NHS can help you get rid of cigarettes. For your free DVD and to find out more, press red or visit gosmokefree.co.uk.
Women call him Good Luck Chuck.
You're a lucky charm. You have sex with someone and then they find their true love.
Now, to get the girl of his dream, Chuck will do anything.
What makes you think I'll be kissing you?
If you sleep with her, she's going to marry the next guy she dates.
I will hate you.
I've got to put the curse to the test.
Or anyone.
I'm going to ride you till you die.
Good Luck Chuck, in cinemas now.
Does your phone receive pictures?
Benylin for children works in harmony with their bodies to relieve a cough.
Wow! And at this price, the tan helmet's simply essential. Now, what's up next, Jane?
Thanks, Mike. Now, after a hard day at the office, the last thing I want to watch is boring, depressing TV like all that news stuff. No, all I want to do is shut down my brain and watch mind-numbing reality shows.
Yes, it's E4's no-brainers, including brand new Simple Life, Beauty and the Geek, and Age of Love with tennis ace Mark Philippoussis.
He's a dish.
Isn't he? Call today and we'll also chuck in these all-American hunks. And that's guaranteed.
I could just hop right in there.
Turn off your mind and switch on your telly box for E4's no-brainers. Mondays and Wednesdays from 10 on E4.
Hello, my name is human, and I come from love. Here on earth, it's easy.
I just wanted it quiet, but they wouldn't shut up. They turned on the telly, the radio. Only my little girl could make it better. Tired now. Will you help me go to sleep?
Close your eyes. The dark outside can't hurt you. I'll never desert your bedside.
I still haven't said thank you.
No need.
It was pretty cool, though. Violent.
And terrifying.
But strangely cool.
Getting chucked out won't be.
She's okay. I've sectioned her. You guys should get back.
Well, that makes it sound like you're not coming with us.
You have to come. You're the least catty girl that I've met. You can't run out on me now.
I'll handcuff you to my wrist and drag you to classes if I have to. Admittedly, it could be slightly impractical when it comes to eating, bathing, going to the toilet. But I'll do it anyway.
I can't, because once the section's over, it'll be just like before, and
there's only me. I thought, stop kidding myself that things could be different.
Lila. Come back with us.
I guess we just go back to classes then.
Like she was never even here.
Talk to them, Lila.
There's no point.
I'm fine now. There's nothing wrong with me. They made a stupid mistake. I don't need to be sectioned.
There's nothing I can do. There never is, like, when you have a psychotic episode and I just stand there. I'm always watching you get worse, trying to stop it. But always on the sidelines, wondering when I get a story of my own.
But you're a part of my life, you and me. Me and you, just two of us. That's the way it should be. That's the way it should always be.
Always?
No, not... not always. That's not what I meant. I just... just for a little while. Just till things are a bit calmer.
No, you meant always. Like a life sentence.
Are you two still miserable? Want to see something that'll cheer you up?
She heard it and got a copy of the recording.
As though I've been transported to a place where happy things occur. Except that something is...
missing.
What's missing?
You said something's missing, so are you gonna tell me what?
I would, but I don't want to boost your ego. You seem like the arrogant type.
The only thing to do with arrogant girls is take them to the bar.
And celebrate their return.
Did you appreciate the dance then?
I did, yeah. The music was really bad.
That's at the same time next week. Well, over on Channel 4, the spotlight is on a few of the less high-profile, or less good, if you like, bands that played the Ibiza Rocks Festival. Like Rumble Strips, We Are Scientists and Foals. Next up tonight, it's Scrubs.
all gone.
Touch and Fresh has all gone. Don't forget.